my name is Joe Hill. I'm the Editor-in-Chief of Circulation, and I'm very pleased today to be here with Professor Daida from Juntendo University in Tokyo, Japan, as well as one of our associate editors, Professor Shinya Goto from Tokai University in Kanagawa, Japan. Dr. Daida is one of the senior authors on a very exciting clinical trial that we're publishing in Circulation, the first and largest trial comparing high-dose versus low-dose statins in Asia. Dr. Daida, would you please tell us more about the study?
Oh, yes. Thank you. The trial called REAL-CAD is a randomized trial. We compared high-dose statin with low-dose statin in Japanese patient with stable coronary artery disease. The number of the patient is 13,000. It's the largest trial ever comparing with high dose and low dose statin. And we found that the significant reduction of the primary endpoint, which is composite endpoint, including cardiovascular death, non-fatal MI, non-fatal stroke, and unstable angina requiring hospitalization. That is really exciting result, because it is the largest trial ever, and also the very first trial in Asia.
Congratulations, Professor Daida, for the great achievement in the REAL-CAD trial. So could you explain a little bit about the background? I mean that the dose of statin in Japan is generally low. And what was the reason why we kept using low-dose trial statin? And is the REAL-CAD trial change the standard of care in Japan and also East Asia? Could you give a comment on those two topics?
Our trial is quite similar to that TNT trial comparing with the extensive statin treatment and the usual statin treatment. However, that extensive statin treatment, intensive statin treatment is not popular in Asia. So we did the maximum approval dose of statin. We use this dose in Japan. That is maximum dose of statin approved in Japan.
So as I understand it, the rationale was the thinking that Asians, East Asians, are unable to tolerate high-dose statin therapy. In this case, you used pitavastatin. And in fact, what you found was there were no increase in serious adverse events in the high-dose patients. And just like Caucasians, they derived considerable benefit at multiple points in atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease metrics.
Actually, that didn't experience the really high dose of statin in Japan. So the government approval is up to 4 milligrams of pitavastatin. That is similar dose of at about 20.
So this is not what we would call high intensity statin therapy, but yet nevertheless, there was a dramatic benefit, including an all-cause mortality, irrespective of the starting LDL level at the beginning of the trial.
That's right. We found that the effect is similar that in the patient greater the LDL is greater than 95 or less than 95. So it's the effect is independent of the baseline LDL level.
So the one thing very exciting, just like Joe mentioned, all-cause mortality, especially non-cardiovascular cause of mortality is reduced with the use of high-intensive care of the statin. So is there any kind of speculation, what is the cause, like reduced inflammation or maybe reduced cancer, something like that? Do you have any kind of advanced analysis?
We didn't have a further analysis, but we are not so keen to emphasize the result of total mortality because maybe that is a chance effect. but this is the largest trial, so the result is really exciting in this kind of aspect.
So I would reiterate Shinya's congratulations. This is a monumental piece of work, the largest clinical trial comparing high dose versus low dose statin, the largest ever, the first in Asia. You found a benefit that makes total sense that across what we know from other trials, and this will change practice. This your work, I believe, will change the way patients with atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease is handled in Japan.
Yes, actually the current guideline in Japan for the secondary prevention, the recommendation is LDL less than 100, and for the really high risk secondary prevention is less than 70. We didn't recommend high dose statin essentially, so this trial result is kind of practice changing.
And I can't resist asking what comes next. What's your next project?
Maybe we need to have a further reduction of the LDL. So we have another drugs, further potent drug recently. So we need to have we need to investigate the role of the new drugs such as PCSK9 inhibitor in secondary prevention.
That's wonderful. Do you have any plan to extend observation of the REAL-CAD trial? I think the trial is relatively still early period as compared to the global long-standing trial. And there is a sign that the effect of statin on the cholesterol and event is different from Japan and other regions of the world. So there is a lot of intriguing thing. So I would like to know whether you are willing to extend the observation or not.
Fortunately, that we do not intend to extend the follow-up. The mean follow-up is about 4 years, but we do not plan to extend. But we will further analyze the data for subgroup and kind of CLP and effect of the event lowering.
So lots of secondary analyses underway, undoubtedly. But let me thank both of you for being here, Professor Daida and Professor Goto. This, I congratulate you again. You know, it's not often that you make a practice-changing observation in modern-day medicine, and I salute you, and we are honored and thrilled to publish your outstanding work in Circulation. Thank you both.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.